I'm going to make a statement that a lot of you are going to shake your head and say, Chaos, that is not true. But I need you to hear me out, because it is true in the minds of some people. And that statement is why people want Ghosts 2. Yep, you heard me right. Call of Duty Ghosts was a super unpopular game when it came out. It launched back in 2013, and many consider it to be the official end of the COD Golden Age. And that's saying something, people. It was ripped apart upon release by gamers everywhere, and it was largely forgotten by most of the community. But in the last few years, as happens a lot, something strange has been happening behind the scenes. Something has changed. A growing group of people on the internet have been revisiting Call of Duty Ghosts and insisting it's a great game and we were all wrong. It was judged too harshly. Are they right? Are they crazy? Well, today, I want to analyze Ghosts as a game, the way it was received, and why so many people are flocking back to it now and giving it way more praise than back in 2013. What's up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the page. Do me a favor. If you're a fan of Call of Duty Ghosts, drop a like. Let me know in the comments what you thought about it then, what you think about it now, and let's talk about it. It launched in 2013, and the development, it was weird. As you probably know, Infinity Ward had a massive falling out with Activision, which resulted in most of the studio resigning after the release of Modern Warfare 2. Now, IW was in such shambles that Sledgehammer was forced to come in and co-develop Modern Warfare 3 because there just wasn't enough time. There weren't enough people working at IW to make it work. And following the completion of MW3, IW grabbed a bunch of new talent, and Call of Duty Ghosts was the first game developed by the new team. Not only was this a massive Call of Duty game being developed by an almost entirely new studio, but it was also coming out at the beginning of a brand new console generation, meaning this mostly new studio had to get the game running on the Xbox 360, the PS3, as well as the Xbox One and the PS4, which obviously was going to lead to some issues. Now, the graphics and performance took a pretty big hit, Fish AI, and this led to a lot of people feeling like Call of Duty Ghosts didn't have much personality compared to the other COD titles. It was gray, it was boring, it was bland, it felt flat, it felt lifeless in comparison to Modern Warfare and Black Ops. These were all critiques that were thrown out, by myself included, which definitely didn't help people's attitudes toward the changes in gameplay. Now, Infinity Ward, they tried to mix everything up the best they could, and it resulted in this very divisive gameplay mechanic. The time to kill, well, it was ramped up like crazy. It made most guns feel melty, and the maps, well, they were made for what looked like a battlefield game of 12v12. The fast time to kill mixed with the extremely open and complicated map design made for the game becoming very slow in comparison to other CODs. Infinity Ward did everything they could to keep the foundation of games like COD 4 and Modern Warfare 2, but with more of a tactical spin. This also meant killstreaks were overhauled and made much less important than previous Infinity Ward games, which is why you go in there and there's really no oomph there's nothing to the killstreaks. In the Modern Warfare series, killstreaks were devastating, and that was by design. But with Ghosts, IW wanted to emphasize more of the player and the teamwork and the skill rather than people getting big streaks going off lone wolf and destroying everybody. Now, most killstreaks in the game, like I said, underwhelming. And it led to the infamous SATCOM, which replaced the traditional UAV and actually required team coordination in order to get it working to its full potential. They really, really wanted you to enjoy the game and it be something unique and tactical, but they ended up screwing with the established formula, which most people don't like and they get upset about. You simply couldn't play Ghosts the way you played Modern Warfare 3 or Black Ops 2, and guess what? That drove the COD community crazy, and it drove a lot of people away. COD is a very simple and casual game at its core, so when you start complicating that, it's not shocking to see why people would back away from it, be apprehensive of it. Now, I mentioned before that Call of Duty Ghosts was a much slower game than previous COD titles, and that's actually part of the reason why people liked it. Because Infinity Ward was putting more emphasis on the slower, more tactical game modes, this means those modes played really well. Search and Destroy was arguably at its all-time best in Call of Duty Ghosts due to the bigger maps and the faster time to kill. Stakes, they were much higher in the game, and the big maps meant there was more space for your team to move around and find alternate routes to bomb sites. The bigger maps, the faster time to kill, It also meant a lot of easier... Well, it meant it was easier for people to clutch up 1v3 and 1v4 situations. And for people watching that competitively, it was a ton of fun. I mean, I was with Team Caliber during Ghost, and it was some of the most hectic matches ever. We got silver at the X Games, and I thought I was going to pass out from anxiety. On the more streamlined three-lane maps, it's easy for players to get overwhelmed with enemies in situations like that, but since they can just funnel to you. But when you have more space to move around, you can make the map work in your favor, and it gives you a lot more options. I'll tell you right now, Blitz was fun. Now let's talk about the gunplay. I mean, seriously, it was fantastic. I don't know what it is about the gunplay in Ghost, but it's some of the best in the series, especially looking back. It's raw. It's punchy. The guns have great feedback. The hit detection was solid, and the sniping was arguably the best in the series. Everything felt snappy. It felt responsive, and that mixed with the sliding and the leaning made for a game with a ton of movement and combat options. Now, in terms of boots-on-the-ground games, I'm going to say this. Ghost had some of the best core gameplay in the entire series. It was just a shame that everything around the gameplay was so divisive. Now, Ghost also had some of the best party games in the entire franchise. Am I turning any of you here? Am I getting you on the bandwagon? It's kind of surprising to think about. Ghost took itself super seriously, and a lot of people hated it for that, but when you actually look at the content included on the disc, you actually had some of the best casual offerings in COD history. Maybe. Maybe because the core multiplayer was so tactical and sweaty, IW felt they needed to compensate and give us some of the best gun game in Infected we've ever gotten in Call of Duty. Infected in particular played excellently on the larger maps because there was more places to hide, hunker down, fight off hordes of enemy players. Now let's talk about the campaign. Well, it's a bit of a mixed bag. Now, the world it set up was interesting, and the characters, they were decent enough. The story has been heavily criticized throughout the years for being very by the books. The marketing material implied was going to be much more stealthy and tactical, but at the end of the day, it was another COD campaign. But sometimes that's what we need. I mean, right? Sometimes we need simple and familiar. And Ghost, they did that. I mean, instead of experimental and outlandish like Black Ops 3 campaign, Ghost also had an infamous cliffhanger ending that I think needs resolved. I mean, come on. There's no way Infinity War wants to leave that ending where it is. You know that just bothers them to no end. So when you put Ghost up next to games like Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops, Black Ops 2, Modern Warfare 3, it's not hard to see why it was hated upon release. It was just way too different, and a lot of people preferred to just stick to what they knew. But with the benefit of hindsight, which is where we're at now in 2020, people have been appreciating the game. Some even call it the best boots-on-the-ground game of the PS4 era. Do I agree? I don't know. It's no secret I wasn't a huge fan of the other boots-on-the-ground COD games, and it's also no secret that I was very, very critical of Ghost for things that it changed, but I also, well, I had kind of a soft spot for it. I had a great time with party modes in the game, and this was back, like I said, when I was with Team Caliber and spending a lot of time in the competitive scene. It was awesome. The elements of Ghost were some of the best in the entire series, so I don't know where I exactly stand in the game right now. It's a weird one to talk about because sometimes it's not so just black or white, good or bad. There's really a lot of good things about it, and there's a lot of bad things. Do I want Ghost 2? Honestly, I think it's a universe worth revisiting and improving upon. There. How many people did I piss off here? How many actually agree with me? You guys, let me know in the comments section. Do you want Call of Duty Ghost 2? And check out the videos on the screen. I'll see you soon.